Hello guys, we are back with how to make and start your own guild in Spiral Knights. So starting the guild will first need an investment of 50k CR and 500k CE, which isn't that much if you're a Vanguard, but if you're a new recruit in Spiral Knights, I wouldn't even advise making a guild so soon, but it's up to you as I always say. So let's get started. First, when you start off, you'll have a guild room looking a little like this. So this is really pathetic if you compare it with any other guild, actually. So you just have to stay positive and determined, and that's basically all you need for the first step. Now let's go. First step, basically you gotta invest more into the guild. The more you invest, the easier it's gonna be for you to start rolling in the new members. Basic components are auction house, it isn't that expensive, some chairs, maybe some tables, and maybe some small furnishments like plants. I wouldn't advise getting statues at the beginning because you need to farm a lot of materials, boss materials especially, and 50k CR for a small statue, that's just ridiculous. So let's go. This is what an auction house looks at Divine Gods. I'm not gonna say it should look like this, but I like to keep some chairs and tables near the auction house because it basically creates a chill zone for guildies to hang out in. Also, at the start you could consider getting the alchemy machine room, because these two basic rooms just boost the activity within the guild. So members don't actually have to go outside of the guild to make their weapons, armor, etc. and do their auction house bidding. So second step, you have to be active in the first days or weeks of the guild. Get to know people and choose which ones you will appoint as officers, so they will help you make the guild better and keep it active. So that's the keeping the guild active part. Next is third step. Basically you have to build elements into the guild, such as room rents, events, etc. For more examples, I'll say Divine Gods has a GP, which is guild currency. GP stands for guild points. It's connected to GM missions. GM missions are practically guildmaster missions. You have to get an item or a certain material. The most usual is a boss material. And these items or materials get mailed to the GM, and you get granted guild points in return. Guild points can be used to buy rank, squads, various items offered by the guild, or room rent. Besides from that, we also have squads and weekly meetings. Weekly meetings are actually, I think, the most important guild element that we have, because we made up a lot of ideas in the guild weekly meeting, because it lets all of the members say their opinion, their proposals for the guild, and what they would like to change and what they would like to add. So that's a good investment you can make for the guild. Now the fourth step. The fourth step is basically maintaining the upkeep and gradually expanding the guild. Since you already invested much into the guild, you have to inspire others to do so. Also, either by making elaborate guild elements such as GP or room rents, or by selling promotions, which isn't good for morality, but a lot of guilds do it. Now, personally, I use room rent revenue to maintain the upkeep, but also have a few elements on the sideline for expanding the guild, such as GP, as mentioned before, and so on, and etc. Now, the last, and I personally think the most important step, is maintaining the guild morality. You'll have various disputes and problems which you'll need to pay attention to as the guildmaster. The choices you'll make will eventually determine the guild's outcome, so my advice to you is simply be patient and don't rush any decisions. Be noble, be fair, all the pretty and good stuff. Put the guild needs above yours, obviously not above real life. You have to be stupid to do that. And boom, you'll have a flourishing guild in no time. All you have to do is use basic knowledge and the things you found out here. If your question wasn't answered, I'd be happy to answer it in the comments below, or you can personally mail me, in Spiral Knights. So, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you learned a few new things from the video. Go like and subscribe. It'll help me out a lot. And leave a comment on what to do next. Goodbye.